You're looking at Ardi, the oldest member of the human family tree, short for Ardipithecus ramidus, a fossil so amazing that those studying her say no one could have imagined it. She lived in Africa 4.4 million years ago. That's about a million years older than the famous Lucy fossil. Not a human, but she's not an ape either, some sort of link between the two. An international team spent 17 years studying the skeleton, and today for the first time they're reporting in detail what they found. Dr. Tim White was one of the researchers on the case. He's at the University of California at Berkeley, but joins me now from Washington. So Tim, what makes Ardi so special?
Well, Jay, it's a combination of her great antiquity and very complete anatomy. But more than that, it's that she's found with a whole bunch of other individuals from her species and found within a very broad ecological context where we have a lot of information from a period we didn't know anything about previously.
So let's take a closer look at her skeleton. It is, according to the group you've worked with, really amazing. Could we sort of look at different pieces? What about the head? What does the head tell you?
Well, we can start from the head down. The head is carrying a brain that's very small, chimpanzee size. And one of the most surprising things about the dentition is that the canine teeth, not just of the female skeleton that we've nicknamed Ardi, but also of the male individuals in the species, the canine teeth are very small, unlike you see in chimpanzees or gorillas. And then to proceed down the body, we get to the forelimb. We have a nearly complete hand of this creature. And when we look at the hand, we realize this is not the hand of an ape. It's the hand of a very peculiar early hominid, the ancestor of Australopithecus. Very curious mosaic of characteristics. We go down to the pelvis, we see the same thing. Adaptations to two-legged walking, but also some primitive characteristics that seem to indicate climbing. And we can see that best in the nearly intact foot that we recovered from that same individual. And it's a foot that actually could grasp with its large toe, like other primates, and unlike all later hominids and humans that came afterward. And so here we have, at 4.4 million years ago, a new kind of creature. And that's why we've given it the new name, Ardipithecus ramidus. It's shedding a lot of light on a period that is more deeply embedded in our past than we've been able to access before.
Well, now, with respect to that foot, you say it's a foot that allowed climbing, but was it a walking foot too?
Yeah, it's a mixture of traits. It could grasp with its large toe, but then it could toe off of the rest of the four rays of the foot as in a biped. So it's a curious mixture. It's a creature that hadn't abandoned its ability to use the trees for feeding and for protection.
Now, does this also say something, Tim, about where it lived? Because one of the ideas that's been pretty popular up to now is that we only took to walking on two legs because the forest receded and our ancestors were forced into the open savanna.
That's right. That's a model that's held for many, many years, and this new evidence really upsets that, because what we're seeing is not just the creature on an empty stage. But due to the work of the 47 colleagues of mine, all publishing in these 11 papers in the journal Science, we're able to sort of bring back an ancient world, all the way from the isotopes in the soil to the pollen grains, the seeds, the wood, and all the other creatures. And every single indicator, all independent, all give us the same picture, that this creature inhabited a woodland environment and was already a biped. So we have to look for other hypotheses, other explanations of why humans started to walk on 2 feet.
Now, at 4.4 million years old, she's still more recent than the time when people think that we split off from chimps. But does her anatomy suggest that even at that point, she's quite far removed from the ancestor of chimps?
That's correct. She has already evolved several key adaptations in the human direction. Two-legged walking, and the reduction of the canine teeth. And so what she does is to extend our knowledge back about 1.2 million years older than what we've known from Lucy and her other conspecifics, members of the same species. This new Ardi skeleton sheds lights in three different directions. One, it informs us about how humans evolved from that point forward along our lineage. Two, it informs us a lot about how much chimpanzees evolved. And it's quite interesting, in fact surprising, that chimpanzees have evolved a great deal. Their hands have evolved more than ours have, from that last common ancestor, for example. And so it takes us closer to that last common ancestor, but that's the quest, to go even more deeply in time and find another skeleton, perhaps 6 and 7 million years ago, and then we will have all of the chapters in our human evolutionary story.
Well, that's a fabulous find. Thanks for telling us about it, Tim.
Thank you, Jay.
Tim White is at the University of California, Berkeley, but joined me today from Washington, D.C.
So did I hear that correctly? They found the skeleton 17 years ago?
They found that skeleton plus a whole bunch of, or pieces from a whole bunch of others. But it took that long to, you know, to make sure. They had to be very, very careful not to damage anything as they extracted it. Quite sensitive to the fact these were treasures belonging to Ethiopia. Plus, as you heard him say, pollen analysis, isotope analysis. So it's a massive piece of work.
Right.
And but the beauty of it is it now allows them to say this was the creature in this environment doing these things.
Do you think it was omnivorous or carnivorous based on the fact that its teeth were smaller?
We didn't talk about that. I would guess that it probably omnivorous, because usually if you're eating vegetation, you have massive jaw muscles, and so, you know, you can see the crest in the skull for that. I think the most amazing thing is that it was walking upright in the forest, and that throws out that old idea that once you got out in the open, that's when you had to walk on two legs.
Mm.
It was a pretty cool find, though, eh?
Very cool.